Oh, there's something there.
Ooh, a treasure chest.
There's something in the bog. Look alive, everyone!
Sorry, Ricota. That would be difficult for me. Donna? Adol, everyone. You came for me.
Why did you run away, Donna? Why can't you leave with us? Do you hate us now?
Of course not. I could never hate you.
You've been such a help to us, Donna. Now it's our turn to help you. Let us help you regain your memories.
Thank you, but this is something I need to do on my own.
I'm sure you have your reasons for acting so stubborn.
The Scarlet Vision. The inevitability of the events I foresee varies depending on their hue. A Scarlet Vision portends events that will come to pass, that cannot be avoided.
Then...
Yes, I saw a scarlet vision of the future after we defeated the Okeanos. And in that vision, I couldn't be with you. One way or another, we will part ways. So don't worry about me. The sooner you get off this island, the better.
Okay.
Huh? What do you mean?
Adol's right. One way or another, we'll part ways. That ain't true just for you. Any one of us could say that. Once we get off of this island, we're all gonna go back to the lives we had before we met. But we're still gonna cherish that we even met in the first place. At least, that's what we're all thinking, deep down in the bottom of our hearts. And I think you're thinking the same thing too, Donna.
Yes, but my circumstances are different from yours.
Consciousness and yours have been connected ever since he washed up here. The same goes for all of us, though perhaps not quite to the same degree as him. Even the other members of Castaway Village have shared in your joy and sorrow. So please, don't walk out of our lives and treat the emotions we all shared like they never happened.
She's right, you know. Come on, think about it. Do you really think Adol can walk away and leave your mystery unsolved? The bond we share can never be broken, because we're all part of the same crew here.
Adol, everyone, as we spent more time together, I started to wish that I could stay with you all. But I knew that wish could never come true. So I ran away, to spare you all the trouble.
I'm happy you care about us so much, but why would you say that?
Yeah.
That's right. You're not the maiden of the great tree here. You can rely on us, as your friends and allies, to support you. We're all facing the same struggle, so we must help each other.
Thank you. I understand. If we are destined to part ways, I want to accept that destiny with a smile and be true to myself when I bid you all farewell. That's why I need to know who I really am. Adol, everyone, please help me restore my memories.
Tally-ho!
I don't know how much help we'll end up being, but we'll do whatever we can.
The Tribaldo always pays their debt in full, no matter what.
I, too, have decided to see this through with everyone. We're all in this together, Donna.
Yes. That cloaked figure told me to go to the Valley of Kings just up ahead. I don't know what hardship awaits me there. I just know that I must overcome it.
Hey, let us through, please!
Where do you think you're going with all that stuff?
Where? Anywhere but here!
We haven't seen the sun in days! We can't live like this anymore!
Just let us pass! You have no right to stop us!
something. Plants are withering from the cold weather. At this rate, the herb... I think the door in the underground sanctuary opened. I don't have much time, but maybe I'll find something there. Thank you.
job!
Progress.
No.
All right, show me.
You did well.
This is a special one.
Together again.
Thanks, everyone!
Treasure!
Allow me to formally introduce myself. It would appear that you have been taking care of Mistress Laxia in my stead. I hope she hasn't proven too difficult for you to manage.
My turn now!
Over here! It's not over yet!
It's gone!
Take this!
Ooh, a treasure chest.
Here!
treasure! Something there. So even maidens weren't allowed to come here, huh? Graves spooked the hell out of me.
I agree. For someone who seems so reserved, Donna, you often take rather bold courses of action.
So you're saying she's reckless?
Hummel!
It's okay. Olga used to say that about me, too. But I wasn't always like this.
Really?
Yes. When I still lived with my family, when my mother was still alive.
Do you understand, my darling Donna? Then I want you to promise me something. Promise me that you will never take off that ring. It's for your own good.
But not every future I saw was a happy one. To be honest, I wish I'd never seen most of the visions that have come to me. Many of them were scenes of pain and suffering. When I was still little, I became withdrawn and depressed from all that I had seen. My mother could tell something was wrong, so she tried to help me by giving me a ring. This ring blocked my connection to essence.
Listen carefully, Donna. The world is a happy place. But sometimes it brings hardship for what feels like no reason. Most people don't want to accept the bad things, so they look away and pretend they can't see them. They do that because their hearts are delicate, and that's not always a bad thing. But you're such a caring child that I know how hard it will be for you to look away. This ring will help you live your life like everyone else. No matter where you go, make sure you always wear it.
After I received that ring, I was finally able to have a normal childhood. I never felt safer than I did surrounded by my parents' warm, unshakable love than one day.
Mommy!
A fire broke out in the shed while my father and I were away and took my dear mother's life. Had I not sealed my powers, I would have foreseen the accident. would have heard my mother's voice crying for help. I felt remorse for sealing my power for the sake of protecting myself. From that day on, I vowed to prevent as much suffering and sadness as I could. Father, I've decided. The houses visited by the messenger are said to receive blessings afterward, right? And if I do become the maiden of the great tree, I'll be able to help a lot of people. I want to do this to honor Mom. How awful, Donna. Since then, I've always felt like I would fade away if I didn't prevent enough suffering. I would get so scared that I would just act without thinking sometimes. And then, I'd just cause more problems for Olga.
Donna.
That's heavy.
It's all in the past now. Anyway, sometime tomorrow we'll be searching the tomb. We should all get some rest.
Olga. Sarai.
You better all thank me!
Yes!
Let's go!
There's something there.
Here.